Mario! Wake up! We've got stars to collect! Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. I'm gonna flop back over to Whomp's Fortress because I'm able to get the red coins on the floating aisle. So, it's another red coin exploration game of sorts. And I think... oh no, there isn't one here. I thought there was a red coin there. Maybe I'm thinking of some other stage here. I don't know. I'm gonna start by exploring by going over to the left side of this level, because I don't actually think I showed you this part, and I won't have to come down here other than for the 100 coin challenges, 100 coin stars I should say. I already showed this actually, and yeah, you just have to ground pound the switch and you'll get blue coins out of them. Remember, blue coins are worth 5. And when you collect them all, the timer stops. You'll hear it instantly, so you know that you got all the coins from it. Okay, there's no red coins that way, so now I can go over here and show you this portion of it, of which there is a red coin at, right there. And be careful of these guys, they try to push you off. I don't know if they have names, but they have eyes. I couldn't really find if they have names or not. Anyway, there's a signboard here. I think it's gonna teach me about the metal cap, but I don't think I need the metal cap in this level at all. It's just there to be fancy. Anyway, if you go up here, wait, maybe it's not that one. Oh, it's that one. It's the other thwomp anyway. So I gotta get on top of the thwomp with the shadow that's over the edge. Shadow texture. There's coin number 2. Jeez. Don't go off edge, please, thank you. Not very good at saving myself in Mario 64, so I expect to have a lot of deaths that way. There's 3, 4, I'm gonna carefully kill you because you are terribly in my way. Yeah. Give me your coinage. Yeah. Oh, that was weird. Okay, now I gotta, in order to get that red coin, I gotta ride that platform around. Well, actually, I could just jump for it straight forward, like, but that's not what they want me to do, and I don't want to fall all the way back down again, so. If you go all the way around, you'll also get a 1-up for your troubles, if you care about them. Anyway, I'm going to take this route around now, and I've got, 5 already. I think I'm on track. Over here, I didn't show this before, there's a bullet bill cannon here. The bullet bills home in on you, and they are invincible, so beware of them. Maybe I did miss a coin somewhere, because there's only 2 coins, two red coins on those islands. Well, I have to go back down anyway, so I'll just do this now. You gotta knock over this plank that defies the laws of physics by getting it wobbling and then kicking it while it's in midair. It's really weird. And you also gotta fight with the camera here a little bit, because it wants to go into like a side-scrolling view, which is not all that handy. I would prefer to have it in a more straightforward, that you're looking where you're going rather than pressing sideways. Yeah, where is that last red coin? I have to be missing it somewhere. I always seem to forget the locations of at least one red coin in my runs, especially in World 4. Oh, there it is! There it is! Oh, I can show you the kick to get up slope! Yeah, oh, dang it. Okay, let's try it again. Nope! I want to use trick. Normally you're supposed to jump down onto that coin from above. I want to show the trick to get up slopes without... I'm not good at this trick. But yeah, if you keep jumping on the slope and then kicking in midair, you'll be able to climb slopes. Might actually just be able to get it like that, yeah. That works. That wasn't the trick I was intending to show you, but I mean, the trick that I want to show you is one that you can use to actually climb any slope that you can have some traction on. It's a sort of way to cheat the game a little bit, but I don't recommend using it unless you really have to. Anyway, there's the star. Here we go! Woo! You know, Mario has one itchy mustache. He always seems to scratch it when he comes out of the paintings. Anyway, next star! This is... Fall into the Caged Island! And this one, we're going to be doing something rather obscure. In fact, the game doesn't really even hint that you're able to do this. Climb up to the top of this tree, and this owl will appear.
Ooh, who's there? Ooh, woke me up. It's still daylight. I should be sleeping. Hey, as long as I'm awake, why not take a short flight with me? Press and hold A to grab on. Grab on, release A to let go. I'll take you wherever you want to go as long as my wings hold out. Watch my shadow and grab on.
So yeah, I just grab on to the owl like so. Keep holding on, and you want the camera to be zoomed out if you can. Oh, it is already zoomed out. Alright, just get yourself over to the star. Oh, dang, camera! It reset itself as I was falling onto the caged island. You see what I was trying to do, though, and the camera just flipped on me. Anyway, if you fail, your owl buddy will be back down here. And come on. It takes a while, though. He's got to actually fly back manually. There's his shadow. Let's try this again. This one, I'm gonna make it my route a little bit wider, so that I can actually so I can actually see where I am aiming. Yes, there we go. That's how you're supposed to do it. Some people like to shoot into that with the cannon, but that's way easier to me. Yeah. Alright, what is next here? Let's see. Blast away the wall, another very easy one. All you have to do is go over to the cannon that you activated over here. And if the cannon isn't activated, just talk to the Bob-Omb buddy here. The cannon is right here. Now this is much more visible in this emulator because you can actually see the edges of the wall sometimes, because of emulation glitches and stuff like that. But you want to aim for this wall. You see where that red coin ring was that you had to ride the platform to get? Aim like right there. There you go, there's the star. Yeah, you actually got to break the wall like that and take damage from it. It's kind of weird like that, so make sure that you have some health when you do that. You could just shoot up over at the star, but I find that an easier way to do this is to go over here and then just simply slide down to the star. Like that. Here we go. I don't really feel like doing the 100 coin stars right now. I think I'll save them for later. I could actually do a 100 coin star right now, but I'd rather have some more I'd rather show off some more worlds in this part. It's just how I feel like I would like to play right now. So I'm gonna go over to the third world, which is Dire Docks, which is ironically marked with a 3-star door. There it is. But first, there's a signboard here. Might as well check that out. I don't really have access to. Wait, actually, I do have access to one of them, don't I? Because I have 12 stars, and I think you need 10 stars for the wing cap. Maybe that's what I should do, actually, is go over and get the wing cap set up. But, well, as long as I'm here, I'll just go in and get one of the castle secret stars. First, there's a 1-up over there. Take some time to admire the aquariums here. The beautiful same kind of fish swimming in schools. Hey, there's Toad. You aren't a fish, but I will chat with you anyway.
Stars are also hits for finding them. They are displayed at the beginnings of each course. You can collect the stars in any order. You won't find some stars, any of these are items, unless you select a specific star. After you collect some stars, you can just try another course. We're all waiting for your help.
Oh, good thing that dialogue box wasn't as long. But I forgot to do Toad at the other Toad that I talked to in the other room. So, my bad there. Anyway, over here is the Secret Aquarium. And there are 8 red coins to collect here, and you have to use the coins to keep your power health meter up. Yeah, because this is completely enclosed and seemingly floating in the sky, or at least we're on top of some sort of tower, because as you can tell, there's clouds all around us. So yeah, there's a coin in each of these rings, and then there's a coin in each of the bottom corners of this room. And that's about it, and then you'll be able to get one of these secret stars. Ah, gotta love this music. So peaceful. So calm. But I don't have a piranha plant to kill this time. Just enjoy it. Enjoy your swim through the secret aquarium, even though you can't stay here for long, because you'll eventually run out of coins and therefore air. Don't know how coins replenish your air, but there you go. And there's your star. There's only one in this area, unlike the princess's secret slide, so just grab it and get out of here. And it'll poop me back over. Oh, I thought it was gonna poop me back at the lobby. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, over here. I don't know if it's gonna show on the emulator, because I think I would have noticed it. Oh, there is light here. How did I not pick up on that? Am I just... Oh, it's because I came out of that door and I wasn't paying attention. Okay, when there's light over here, this light appears when you have 10 stars. Go into first person mode, look up at the light. They'll be transported to the Wing Cap course, and I'll step on that switch once I finish my flight here. I've got to get eight coins around the tower here, so flight controls are a lot like swimming, except you're going a lot faster. So down is up is down, like airplane controls. And okie dokie. And once I hit the Wing Cap switch on top of the tower, all red blocks will become solid. I'm going to aim for both these at once by going straight through the middle of them. Yes! Now I'm going to follow the pathway down and around. Oh geez, I'm going fast. Going really fast. Got him. Follow the coins. Follow the coins. Oh shoot! That's not good. I hope I'll be able to go back around. Come on, Mario. I think I have enough height to do this. Don't lose altitude. Don't stop losing altitude. No, I don't have enough. Okay, I'm gonna have to ground pound and restart this. Flying is more like gliding. So once you lose your altitude, you kind of, you can't get any more height on it. And it's kind of, it's kind of annoying to do that. Anyway, I mean, it's kind of annoying to fly. It's called, this place is called the Tower of the Wing Cap, by the way, just thought I would mention that. So with flying, you can't really gain height easily. You have to start from a high place, and that's why you can't really get the red coins unless you're already starting from the top of this place. Once I get the wing cap activated, oh shoot! Missed one. Go around, Mario. I think I still have a chance. Keep it steady. Keep it steady. Yes, got it. And that'll produce a star on the tower. I'm going to land here. And don't forget to hit the switch while you're here. You stepped on the wing cap switch. Wearing the wing cap, you can soar through the sky. Now wing caps will pop out of all the red blocks you find. Yes, I would like to save. So yeah, these translucent red blocks over here produce wing caps. And when you put them on, you can do so. You can fly, and you can also triple jump in place to be able to fly instantly. So that's a special power of the wing cap. Anyway, I am going to grab the star and get out of here, because I had more trouble with that one than I should have. I think what I'm going to do now is go back over to the first world and finish off the other two stars that are not a 100 coin star. So let's go. The first one is Mario Wings to the Sky. Since I just activated the red wing cap switch, I'm now able to do so quite easily. Well, maybe not that easily. This star is still a little bit annoying to get. I'm going to quickly get myself over there, though. You have to go over to the top of that floating island again. Yeah, it's a pretty popular place to go to in this world, isn't it? So, yep, looped forward. Shoot out and land. Oh, no, not in the cannon. Okay, so over here is the cap, and when you use the cap while flying in a cannon, you'll be able to fly straighter and farther than you did before. Now, remember that there is a thing that said there's special spots that you have to touch in order to get a star from? This is one of them. You gotta fly through the center of all these rings to make the numbers appear. And, oh, I shot too high. Well, I got two of them at least. I'm gonna go back over to the island. I'm gonna take a guess I'm over it. No, I'm not! And I'm gonna take damage from that. I just couldn't tell where I was due to the perspective, and yeah. Alright, back down I go. So you've seen two numbers appear there, one from the first ring and one from the fourth ring. So I gotta aim for 2, 3, and 5 still. Oh shoot, shoot, I forgot I got the wing cap. And I killed myself on one of the easiest stars in the game. I mean, sure, it's annoying to get, but what I mean is that it's there's nothing threatening or in your way that'll prevent you from getting the star all that easily. Now that's just embarrassing. Anyway, I suppose it happens sometimes. Oh yeah, I should also mention, since I just showed you there, you take fall damage from when you fall from too high of a spot. If you are able to ground pound before you hit the ground, you'll be able to save yourself from taking damage. But I did it too high up and I ended up taking damage. I think my angle's a little too shallow. Oh no, it's fine. Okay. Alright, one more time. Gotta do it until I get it. So I guess it's not just one more time, it's however too many times I need in order to do this. Alright, so I'm gonna aim low this time because I know the trajectory. It's so hard to hit those spots. You're not gonna die doing this very often, obviously, but it's just a thing of, it's hard to control your flight so quickly. Right, I'm just gonna guarantee myself. 2, 3, 4... Oh! I didn't touch the control stick and I hit all of them! That's the trick! Aim for the first ring center coin and don't touch the control stick at all. No wonder I had so many issues with that star. Because I always touch the control stick. Well, another one bites the dust. And I think I'm gonna finish off all the stars in Bob-Omb Battlefield by doing Behind Chain Chomp's Gate. Well, it's not the last star. I still gotta get the 100 coin star, but you know what I mean. So anyway, you remember that Chain Chomp right at the beginning, right? Well, there are these posts that you can pound in the ground by doing ground pounds. Well, pound it in, and it's really dangerous to pound that post in, but once you do, you'll be able to free the Chain Chomp, even though it doesn't sound like a good idea, it is. You'll be able to free the Chain Chomp, it'll be very happy, it'll break the cage, and you'll be able to get the star behind that gate! Oh shoot. Get on the post. I'm gonna do that, and yes, I wanted him to go under me. Nope, get! This post is so annoying sometimes. I need more coins. I need to stay alive. I will survive! I just came over here because I knew there was those two red coins. This post is so annoying to get on top of. Especially when you're under pressure like that. Okay, 1, 2, 3! Yes, got it! I was just ground pounding the post while the chomp was in the way because I could hear that I had it. Yeah! And that's how you get the star. So collect it and get out of here. Woo! Here we go! And with that, I think I'm gonna end off the part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part.